Hi, I'm Chef Costa Magoulas. In this episode of Local Flavor Restaurant Edition, we're going to explore the Eastern European cuisine in Central Florida. So stay tuned. Chef Costa Magoulas, and today we're going to be cooking, tasting the dishes of Eastern European cuisine with the help of my guests. I'm here with Julia Klimova. Is that pretty close?
Yeah, that's good, okay. Actually.
From the Ararat Bistro. Welcome to the show today,
Thank
Julia.
Thank you very much for having us.
I looked around at all this food you brought to the show. I can't stand it. I want to reach over here and eat this and grab that.
I know.
Listen, folks, this is a call-in show, so don't forget our number is 1-800-901-9238. 1-800-901-9238. Please call us with your questions about the show, about the food, about what we're doing, anything you want. So tell us about the restaurant. How long has it been there?
Well, we've actually been open for almost 7 years. And first we started as just a store. And then all of our customers really loved it. And they asked us to open a restaurant. So we done it.
Boy, that's a good reputation right there, right? Well, we were talking about the location now. Where is it located at?
Well, we're located in Orlando. It's on Universal Boulevard, and there is like a few minutes away from Wet n Wild.
Well, you're right in the middle of all the action.
Yes. That's right.
Well, I appreciate you coming over here with all that traffic over there, okay?
I know.
Well, listen, we're going to be talking about the restaurant, and we're going to be looking at it, too. We want to talk about who came up with the design and what it looks like inside. And there's the restaurant we're talking about, Ararat. I see you have outside tables as well, but that looks pretty. What is it, a waterfall inside?
Yes, that's waterfall, and we have some tables outside, but all the fun is happening inside.
So who came up with the design?
Well, actually, one of our friends, he helped us to design it, and we have some decoration from our customers who brought us some gifts, so we decorated it.
Oh, really? It's really pretty neat. It really looks nice inside, too. You got all kinds of stuff going on.
Yes, we do.
So how many people do you serve a day? You have an idea?
The traffic is really always.
Oh, it's really?
Yes, it's always busy. Some days less, some days. Yeah, it depends.
I was looking at your menu there and the way it's set up and everything. It really looks like it's spacious, so you have plenty of room to move around in. And I see the kitchen area. I don't see you in the kitchen, Julia.
I stay away from the kitchen. I leave it to our chef.
You're the front of the house, right?
Yes, I stay in the back.
Well, it looks like some good action in there. Well, we're looking at the restaurant. It's been there for 7 years. Quite frankly, I'm excited about this. We're talking about Eastern European cuisine.
Yes.
And a lot of people don't know what that means. I mean, what countries? That involves a lot of countries, right?
A lot of countries, yes.
Yeah, and I know we were talking to some friends of ours that are Armenian, and some are Hungarian, and they were saying, oh, yeah, I'm used to that food. And I said, oh, because I kept thinking it was one cuisine. That looks like the mountain that was named after, right?
Yes, that's Mount Ararat. It's actually a very good story on the Bible. That's where Noah's Ark was found, on Mount Ararat, and they also call it a holy mountain.
Yes.
Yes.
Now, you get your customers from out of town, locals? I mean, is it?
People come from all over, not just America. We have from other countries coming to us.
Really?
Too. Yes.
Well, that's pretty neat. That's pretty unusual to get them from, not unusual, from all over, because there's so many visitors to Orlando. I'm looking at those pancakes you're cooking, too. Ooh, that looks good. We're going to be doing that later on in the show. And so anyway, we were talking about our diners coming in. Is that a movie that's going on inside the show?
We can put some movies. We can put some different shows, some music, whatever you want.
Well,
we
folks,
have it.
Well, folks, don't forget, this is a call-in show, 1-800-901-9238. So we were looking at the menu. Who created the menu?
Well, our chef, she has 31 years of experience.
Oh, wow.
Yes. She, the only thing she asked me not to say is how old she is, but between you and I, she's 50. But don't tell I told you.
Well, so, you know, yes. We were talking about the menu a little bit. Do you have something that's the most popular dish or...
Every single dish is very popular. If it's not popular, we don't keep it. Yes.
Well, I was looking at, there's so much variety on this menu. And if you look here on the table, some of the things we have are just amazing. But is there anything on the menu that jumps out that people order a lot of at all?
Everything. Soup, salads, main dish.
Well, we were looking at some of the things. Like you have smoked salmon, shuba.
Yes.
And we have that here in front of us, right?
We do.
This is smoked salmon shuba right here. I'd pick it up, but I was told not to touch it because it's so fragile. It looks beautiful. What is salmon smoked shuba?
Well, it's it's a great salad. It's actually a salad, if you have any birthday, Christmas, New Year, you guarantee you're going to have this dish on a table, yes. So it's a smoked salmon. There is some boiled vegetables. You can see there is beet, so it's nice and pretty, colorful. And there is some eggs and a little bit of mayonnaise.
Now, I noticed you also do like beef patties with buckwheat.
Beef patties?
Well, you know, like beef, it's almost like a little...
Well, we do patties, yes. There is different filling, but not with buckwheat.
Oh, really?
Yeah, okay. But we have like... mashed potatoes, we have cabbage, you have over there actually cheesy filling, so that's really good.
Look beautiful. It looks like it doesn't look real. It's so perfect. So there's all different types.
Yes.
Those are very popular pierogies. I know that. People like to eat them a lot. I'm reaching over here for one, but I know I better not do that.
You can do it after the show.
Now, I was told that buckwheat is a popular dish in the Eastern European countries. They use it a lot in their cooking and everything.
Yes, it's actually, you can use it as an alternative to rice, and you treat it as rice. So you need to rinse it same way, you need to cook it same way. And a lot of people have it for breakfast, so it's very healthy for you too. So you have buckwheat, kasha in the morning, glass of milk, you're good to go.
That sounds too healthy. Well, let me ask you now. I see a lot of things here that you brought with us. Now, are these exotic things? Is it hard to get? I mean, where do you get all these ingredients?
Well, all the stuff, you either come to our restaurant, we feed you with all the great food, or you can
come
actually
to our store. We're looking at the store right now.
That's
your whole place. My goodness gracious, look at all the things in there.
We have everything.
So if you need anything that we have here, you have it at the store, right?
Exactly.
That's a good idea. Go right next. Is it right next door?
It's right next door, yes.
Okay. And I noticed you have beer and wine. We didn't talk about that too much, but do you have beer and wine at the restaurant as well?
Yes. There is different kinds of beer, different kinds of wine.
Well, you know, I love these little cookies, little round cookies. I like to put them in my coffee. They're so good. They're not real sweet.
Yes, I prefer it with tea or just like that when I'm driving.
Boy, look at all the things in there. That's amazing. Boy, you got everything. No, caviar, meats, salmon. It's great. And I'm looking at caviar right in front of me, and it's driving me crazy. I just want to reach over here and grab it. Listen, folks, don't forget, it's 1-800-901-9238. So we're going to be doing something down here in just a few minutes. We're going to be putting a soup together. Is that correct?
Yes,
Aruska.
Akroshka.
Akroshka.
You almost got that right.
I'm getting close,
okay? You are.
We have a video coming up shortly about how to make beef stroganoff, which is a very popular dish at the restaurant. Is that correct?
Yes, it's very popular.
We have a caller on the line from Debbie. Let's see what Debbie wants to ask us. Debbie, what's on your mind?
Hi, good evening. I was just curious if you guys do any type of parties or any type of catering there?
Well, we actually have a lot of people who come over there and want to celebrate. And we can actually provide with a DJ, with karaoke. You come to our place.
So they could sing and everything,
yeah,
right?
Yes, yes, of course.
Well,
I told
do they
it's
have
a fun
entertainment
place.
Or is it just everybody has fun?
Sorry?
Do you have entertainment that comes in and plays?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
If you wish, yes, we can bring the DJ, You can have karaoke. You just come, sit back. I don't.
Well, you don't cook. I figured you might be in the front singing a little bit.
Maybe a little bit later, after a few glasses of wine.
Okay. Well, I'm with you. We couldn't drink any wine tonight. I have to, this bottle next to you just is insane. I love it.
I know, and they don't let me open it right now. So that's a shame.
Isn't that beautiful?
Yes.
Okay, we're going to be talking about the beef stroganoff here in just a second, and we're going to show how it's made.
Okay, perfect.
All right, so here it is. We're in the kitchen at the restaurant.
Yes. And
I'm sure she's not going to give me her secret ingredient, but now, no. Is she using beef?
She used a beef sirloin, so she just cuts them to pieces. They don't have to be too thick, but not too thin either, you know. And you put on a pan.
Now she's got a nice saute pan there.
Yes,
with
the oil have to be hot, otherwise it's not going to be too good.
Because you're just going to sear it a little bit on
exactly.
each side. Gotcha.
So she adds some salt, pepper. So she just let it fry. She adds some flour to make it a little bit thicker.
Okay.
That's cooking wine.
I'm sure there's something else in there. She won't tell you what it is.
I will not. That's the secret ingredient.
There it is. She's putting her sauce in, right?
Yes, that's
looks
that's
like a nice little demi-glaze or
yes.
brown gravy of some kind.
And just a little bit of sour cream.
Now you put that in at the end, right?
Yes.
It's very important when you cook this dish that it's hot, because when you put the sour cream in, it doesn't curdle.
Yes.
That way it mixes up real good, right? Oh my goodness, I love
so
beef stroganoff.
Yeah, some fresh herbs, cilantro, parsley, anything you have is good to go.
Now, are there different variations of this dish? I mean, do you have to use beef or what?
No, you actually have a choice. You can have chicken, you can have pork, you can have lamb if you want.
Really?
Yeah.
And when you come to the restaurant, you can just tell them how you want it
yes,
like that?
Yes.
Oh, that's great.
So you have
I like
lots
that
of
idea.
Choices.
Somebody was telling me that they even make it with liver.
They do, yes. We have also with liver. So for any taste, we have
every
dish.
Look at that dish. Isn't that beautiful?
It's delicious.
Well, look at that. Bring it to me right now. I'll take it. Have that bottle of wine. We'd have a good time. You can do the karaoke while I'm eating, okay?
What about me? Just wine? No eating
oh,
for me?
Oh, okay. Listen, we're going to do a little bit of something here. We're going to put together this aruska soup.
Akroshka.
Akroshka.
Yes.
See, I did it again.
You did it again, but that's okay.
Okay, so we're going to mix it up. You want to come over and
yes,
tell us what
sure.
we're doing here? Is that the bowl we're putting it in?
Well, that's the bowl we're going to put everything
okay.
in. Do you have a gloves I can
Yes, I do.
Use? Perfect.
You're not going to use your bare hands?
No. No. When you come to our restaurant, if the chef will see
Thank
you,
you.
Come
I
on.
Noticed she had gloves on in the kitchen, too. Don't forget, folks, our number is 1-800-901-9238, and we're getting ready to make akroshka soup. Is that better?
That's better.
I'm murdering
By
it,
the time
I know.
We'll finish with the soup, you might get the name, so that's okay.
Well, go ahead, get started. What do you have
okay,
here?
Okay, so we have some boiled potatoes.
Okay.
You just put on the plate. Some fresh cucumbers.
Now, soup is a popular dish in Eastern cultures, right?
Yes.
Right. Now, this is
this
mortadella?
This is mortadella, yes, correct. So,
you know, one of my favorite things is mortadella. I have to make sure this is good, okay, before you put it in there. Yeah, it's okay. You can
it's
put
good?
It in.
It's good. Okay. So we have some boiled eggs.
Mm-hmm.
Just put nice and pretty.
You slice them up so nice.
Well, all our dishes that comes out, it doesn't only taste good, it has to look good. That's the rule.
It has to look good.
That's
okay.
The rule.
All right, what else are we putting in?
And we have
radishes?
Some radish. Yes.
That's interesting.
And that's actually, it's already mixed. It's yogurt.
Okay, this is your sauce, right?
That's our sauce.
Tell
yes.
us what's in. I see dill in there.
There is dill, there is parsley, there is cilantro. So you add a little bit of salt, a little bit of pepper, and a little bit of
Just
vinegar.
Just pour it in?
Just pour everything in. And it's actually a great dish for when it's so hot. And Florida is always hot. You can add a little bit more.
I'm sure glad you're trusting me with this. I thought that was dangerous, really. Here, let me get this out of your way.
And then you can just add just a little bit on top.
Oh, that looks beautiful.
So it looks nice and pretty.
Now, this is a cold soup, correct?
Yes, correct.
Now, people like cold soups? Eastern, is that what they prefer?
Well, we have different kinds of soup, but that's the one we just wanted to show you, because when people think of soup, they always think of hot soup.
Yeah.
So that's something different that people did not try before, so that's what we want to bring for you to try.
Well, are there different variations of this soup, or is it pretty standard?
Yes, this soup, actually, you can have it either with yogurt or you can have it with kvass.
Oh, really? I like yogurt, too. I think that's nice. Well, I got news for you. We're going to put this recipe card up here, I believe. But before we do that, it's already up. That's the recipe card. You want to tell everyone what's on in the recipe while I eat the soup?
Okay.
Oh, my goodness gracious.
You do the best job. You eat and I talk. Okay. Well, there is, as I said, there is boiled potatoes, some fresh cucumbers, some mortadella, some radish, some boiled eggs, yogurt, salt, pepper, vinegar, and some fresh herbs.
I'll tell you what, I think I'd like to finish this soup right now, but they won't let me, so
I'll... You can do it after the show. It's fine. I will not touch it.
Okay.
I'll try.
We have another call from Alan. No, Alan, you cannot have the soup. I'm eating it. That's it. What's your question, Alan? And Julia, you can't either.
Well, I enjoy beef stroganoff, and I was hoping for any tips on making a really good beef stroganoff at home.
A real good what?
Oh, a really good beef stroganoff at home.
I did not get the question.
Oh, how to make it at home, at home. Okay. Well, he wants to make the beef stroganoff at home.
Okay.
And if you saw the procedure, it's pretty straightforward, isn't it? You know, you have to have a nice saute pan and some butter oil to put into the pan. And when you do that, you get it nice and hot, and then you go ahead and put the meat in just like we're talking about. Now, she said that they use tenderloin. It's tender. You can't use a tough piece of meat for stroganoff, because you're only going to cook it slightly,
yes. And
it's going to be tough. So you have to have a nice piece of meat in there, some kind of a steak that's nice and tender, or the tenderloin. And you put it, do you put onions in yours or anything like that?
You can. It's what's your preference.
Yeah, so you could take that as an option for yourself. But once you get that cooked down, you can put a little bit of beef stock in there and cook it. And once you get it cooking and put a little bit of flour, it'll start to thicken up for you. And then you'll find that it's almost done. You know, that meat doesn't take very long. You saw in the movie there. And then you finish it off with some nice sour cream. It's finished. I hope that helps you. Okay. We're going to do something else here in a sec. You can try this now if you want.
Okay. I was hoping
you
were going to offer me some. Otherwise, you're eating all by yourself.
Is that good?
You want some more?
Well, I'm going to put it over here with... Okay, I'll put it over there if you want.
Don't put it too far away.
I'm going to have to move it.
Okay.
I think she got mad at me that I moved it. Okay, we're going to make one more dish here. The final dish for today's show is sirniki.
Sirniki.
Say that again.
Sirniki.
She said it. I didn't. Here we go. I'm going to bring it out, okay? Please tell us about this dish.
Well, this is our very good dessert, very tasty. We use farmer cheese.
Now, farmer's cheese, you find that in the grocery store. That's pretty common cheese.
Yes, but we also have it in our store. So we try different farmer cheese from different stores.
You're trying to get me to drive to Orlando to get the cheese. I can hear you now.
Of course. No, I'm trying to get you not only to the store, but to our restaurant. Look at this.
Well, I'm going to do that anyway. Now, there's flour on this because you rolled it out real nice.
Yes, so you add some flour, some sugar, baking soda, egg, and you just roll it.
And on the show, we tried to get it because we're really kind of limited for time. So I'm going to go ahead and get this cranked up, turn my stove on. So you just cut it into little pancakes?
Yes.
Tell me, what do you need?
Okay, let me
You want to put it together?
Yeah.
Okay. Am I doing this right?
Cut
you want
like
a big one?
Pieces.
Oh, that'll cut. Yeah. Don't worry. So now, do you flatten it?
Can I borrow your gloves again so I can help
sure.
you out? I don't want you to mess up. Okay?
See, she's already correcting me. I thought it was here 2 seconds.
I just want that you will get this dish correctly so, you know,
yeah,
we
you're
can,
doing
you
good.
Can cook
you're
it
doing
in
real
house.
Good. Oh, let me get that off for you. Go ahead and get you another one. Well, I see what you're doing. Okay.
Yeah.
All right, I get it.
Brown ones, and then we put little bit cuts like this, so when it's cooked, it's nice and pretty.
Now we need 400 of these, okay? So you got to move a little faster. <all right? laughs>
Are you sure you're going to be able to finish? We're going to be here all night. I need to get back to Orlando.
I'll start getting these. See how fast that is?
Well, of course it's fast if I'm doing most of the work.
Gee whiz, I was just... Thank you.
I'm just saying.
Yes, ma'am, I understand. I ate the soup. Now I'm just watching you and you're picking on me. And you have a perfect right to. Sound just like my wife now. Oh, that looks good. That you know, gosh, those things are looking beautiful. Don't forget, folks, our number is 1-800-910-1-9238. And we're kind of winding down here. But we still got a little bit of time left. And if she lets me eat one of these, I'm not sure. We have a call from Orlando. Jack from Orlando, you there?
Yes, sir.
What's your question, Jack?
Yeah, it smells delicious, beautiful. I just want to ask you if they sell champagne, Russian champagne, and wine.
What? Russian champagne?
Do you sell Russian champagne?
Yes, we do sell Russian champagne, actually, and it's very popular. And sometimes it goes so fast that we have to, we usually try to get our orders, you know, extra because Christmas is coming, New Year's is going to go fast.
Well, I didn't
fast.
See any here tonight.
It's
I
not
didn't
Christmas
see my glass
yet.
Or anything else.
It's not, I brought you some wine.
I know you did. Oh, that, I love it. We got to get these out of here. This thing is cooking too hot. The recipe card is up on this. And you want to just go over that one more time with them?
Yes, so it's Parma cheese, cottage cheese, eggs, sunflower, sugar, pinch of salt, and baking soda. And you can have different toppings. We serve it with sour cream. I actually brought some.
I have sour cream if you want. Yeah,
yes.
Okay. And I also have powdered sugar.
Exactly.
I don't know which one you want.
Both.
Let me get
both,
this thing out
please.
Of here. Sounds good. Okay. Let me turn this thing off. Here, I'll get them for you, Julia. Okay. Here, let me, there's the sour cream. I'll put it on if you want. Boy, these things are fragile. They're so beautiful.
That's why I told you, you need to be careful.
Well, you were fussing at me earlier. I didn't want to say anything.
And then you put some sour cream.
Now, do you want sour cream on this?
Yes.
Okay, now, can you substitute something else for the farmer's cheese?
Some people don't put anything. You can put sour cream. You can put
is
some
that okay, or is that not acceptable? You want
it's
more?
Okay. It's okay.
Boy, she's tough to deal with. Okay. I tell you what I'm going to do. I'm going to really get you, okay? Hang on a second.
What, you going to bring me some wine? Or more sour cream? Oh, perfect.
How about that?
See, that's good. Now we're talking.
Okay, we're winding down here. Is there something real quick you want to tell me about the restaurant that we need to know about?
Well, it's a great place to be. You come to our place, we take care of you. You're going to have really fun.
Okay. Well, folks, we're going to close up here with the beef stroganoff and our patties and everything. Our wine pick for tonight is a Rodney Strong Merlot Sonoma to go with the beef stroganoff. That's our suggestion from Chef Jeff Conklin. So, folks, we're here winding down at the end. Thank you, Julia, for unfortunately we're out of time, and thank you for joining us. Thank you for coming down with all this food, too. I can't tell you how much I appreciate it. If you didn't get your questions answered, you can email us at wdsc@daytonastate.edu. Or check our Facebook page and do that hands up sign. If you have any questions for our guests, you can always ask them on their website at araruro.com. Thank you for joining us, and we'll see you next Thursday for the new edition of Local Flavor Restaurant Edition. Thank you, Julia.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Can we now try?